Rush me, Spider, Exocet, Oscar, Maureen, Special Girl, PJ, and Chapter 4. We've just been told that Spider is out, thank you.
This is the 1991 Toronto Spectacular. 6 litre. Championship.
Close to the field in front of the control tower now. It looks like the only other boat to come out is the one on the ramp. So your pole positions are... We won't alter them because there is a boat that has been withdrawn, so you will have to sort yourselves out there because the pole draw has been made. In pole position 1, the Colonel. In 2, Outcast. 3, Truck Z. 4, Rucknut. 5, Repeater. 6, Maureen. 7, Heartache. 8, Spider. 9, Freight Train. 10, Cookie. 11, Exocet. 12, Misprint. 13, Special Girl. 14, Chapter 5. And on the outside is PJ. We've got 8 boats out there now. There are another 5 to come out. It's scrutinised. Thank you, Chapter 4. You pulled your cut out for us. Thank you very much. Flag is still up at this stage. It's a fairly good line looking from here. Although we are looking straight onto them, so it's very hard to tell. The pole boat is the only one that knows. Still up at this stage. Come towards the fig tree boy. It's down. They are racing. Hello, there comes the short straight. Oh, what's the name? 4. Chapter 4 that was. He's gone around the wrong side of the course. Hello, someone's got a red flag up for some reason.
Red flag up. Restart.
Do a time trial.
Everything looks spick out.
Meantime, though, we'll pick up the field as they come down now. The flag is still up at this stage. There is one boat hanging back a bit.
Yep. Mate, he could have killed somebody. It's as simple as that.
Flag is down. They're racing. PJ's the boat on the outside that is running around, from Misprint. Rucknut is the next one, then Trust Me.
They're Outcast.
One on the outside of Trust Me is very hard to pick up. I think it's Exocet, yes, then Cookie, and at the rear is still Freight Train, but it's all PJ, so he goes into the Big Tree Boy for the first time. Hit a bit of a hole as he went past the start finish point, got out of the water a fair bit. PJ's running around in this event looking prize money. He's only throwing the boat out for tomorrow, for the big event tomorrow. I think it's the Northern District or the Open Unlimited. I'm not sure which event.
That
is the Open Unlimited, it's the Northern District. But it's Outcast, Wrong Misprint, Rough Nut, Great Train. Trust me. Exocet, Cookie, and Freight Train just going into the southern end of the course. Yellow flag will go out now. All the boats as they come down past us for the second last time. Here we have PJ. Outcast is the first one to receive the yellow. Not much between the next four boats, so it's Misprint from Rough Nut, Mistrust me, Exocet. Cookie just coming out of the victory boy as Freight Train goes in. PJ. But Outcast will come down now. PJ is bigger than a 6 metre, but Outcast will come through to get the checkered flag. First place to Outcast. These are all unofficial, ladies and gentlemen. All depends on what the start post is. Misprint is the next one, followed by Rough Nut. Trust me. Exocet is the next boat. Waiting on Cookie Shoe and Freight Train to finish the event. Cookie, sorry. Six-litre boats, we want you out in front of the control tower immediately, please. The Black Reef.
This is the 4.2 litre inboard displacement.
Bloodshot, you are pole position 4. Cujo, you are 3. Thank you. Waterbeach is having a bit of fuel problems. bringing them down for a start now.
The 4.2 litre inboard.
Yeah, the flag is down, they're racing. Not much in it as they get going. It looks like Cujo and Special Girl. Not much between Special Girl and Cujo. It's Special Girl just in front of Cujo and Bloodshot with Keen at the rear. Not much at all in between these two. Indicating one lap to go for these boats. They're all under caution because we have a boat drifting out onto the course here. As soon as the crash boat gets out there, there'll be a boat on the course. Receive the checkered flag. It's Special Girl in front of Cujo, but it's all Special Girl as they receive the checkered flag now. Cujo next. Bloodshot will come through in third. Waiting on Keen to finish. Caution flags have come down now. Keen will come through to receive the checkered flag. That'll be all boats completed. We'd like to thank all spectators, drivers and crews for coming today, and hope to see you here bright and early tomorrow. I've been told the start was A-OK, so it was as they crossed the line. First, Special Girl. Second, Cujo. Third, Bloodshot. And fourth was Keen. That completes racing for today, ladies and gentlemen. Like as I said, hope to see you here bright and early tomorrow morning. Don't forget any late arrivals. If you know of anybody that's coming tomorrow and are going to race in handicap racing, be here ready to race at 9 a.m. Time trials should be a little bit before then, I would think, and driver's briefing at approximately 8:45 a.m. in the morning. Thank you. Hot Lemon, and Running Wild. Walkabout is on the course somewhere. He's got to show us that his kill switch is working though. And Running Wild 11. You are in the starter's hand, drivers. Ladies and gentlemen, this is one of the big races of the day. This is the straight up and down course. Five times past the control tower. First lead the Ken Wagon Memorial. It is a very fast race, ladies and gentlemen. Hag is down on there racing. Sorry, the flag is not down. He must be happy with the line. No, he's not happy. He's turning him around. There's a few hanging back, apparently wanting a run through. You'll have a bit of shade. Racing. Oh, very hard repeater, Running Wild on the outside. Also, very hard to pick it from here. But not much between repeater and Running Wild as they go towards the southern boy for the first time. Running Wild going very wide. Repeater though at this stage. Can't take the second boat. Running Wild stayed out wide to keep his reps up, but it's a repeater as they go towards the big three boy for the first time. It's Problem Child running second, Brom running wild. Very hard to pick them up when they're out on that straight course. Well, we'll pick them up again. There is another one in there. I think it was Maureen. And they sort themselves out though as they go down towards the southern boy for the second time. Yes, it's Running Wild, Maureen, Problem Child, then Running Wild. Cut Loose would be the next boat. Keep our eye on them as they go into the southern boy for the second time. Not much between Problem Child and Running Wild there, but it's all repeater as they go up the back straight once again from Maureen. The next one then, Problem Child, Running Wild. Cut Loose just coming out of the boy. We have one withdrawal that's gone to the centre of the course to one of the crash boats. No problem there. Watch them as they come out of the big three boy once again. Oh, that was a close one for Maureen. Nearly hit the boy, but he missed it. Very tight turn for Maureen, trying to make up ground, but it's all repeater as they go down towards the southern end of the course. Once again, next time round, they'll receive the yellow flag indicating one lap to go. The next one then would be Problem Child from Running Wild. I can't pick up the next three or four. The next one would be running Cut Loose. Then I think Hot Lemon is the next one. I'm not sure. No, it's Special Girl, the yellow boat. I should have known that boat. Oh, we've got our one. Red. Problem Child it was.
It's red over.
Right up it went. Oh, he went right up. He went right up. I hope the driver is A-OK. It's very hard to tell. He's the driver is out of the boat. I can see him moving around.
Chief Speedway, come on.
Oh, yeah.
Mate, they've got possessed off the bottom here before.
All the ramp area cleared. No spectators or anything around the ramp. This trailer is in the water, apparently. But
yeah,
The driver of Black Russian, the driver of Black Russian, could you go to your boat immediately, please? That is a request from the pit marshal. Driver of Black Russian, to your boat immediately, please. Spectators, please stay away from the ramp area.
There you go, the gym are going.
Leave it there or pull it before?
No, they pull it out.
Right.
They want to make sure it's
sparkling.
Freeze bottle.
Even if they do, they
can get a problem. Battery.
Now let's drive that thing, boy.
And you pull the lever.
There you go. Someone knows it.
Safely out of the southern end of the course. Repeater goes into the fig tree boy for the final time. This time round he'll receive the checkered flag. Don't forget, ladies and gentlemen, these boats and drivers and that come back in, put your hands together for them. There we have Repeater first, Running Wild second. All these places are unofficial until we get the AOK from the start boat. Maureen's coming through now, has backed off a lot because he doesn't want to damage the boat because of the second heat. We'll get third placing, Maureen. Anguish coming through now in fourth, followed by Cut Loose, and the Coal made up a lot of ground on Cut Loose. But it's going to be close between Cut Loose and the Colonel for fifth and sixth. But it's Cut Loose, the Colonel, and Little Special Girl at the rear of the field. That's all boats completed now. The black recall flag will go out. Come on, driver. Second heat of the Northern District, unlimited, unrestricted. The boats we want are Heartache, Rough Nut, Sink Sink, Misprint, Trust Me, Maniac, Cobber, Trust Me is a withdrawal, Chapter 4, Liberty, Possessed, Contagious, Black Russian and TJ. Black Russian and Contagious have got to come out and pull their kill switch, also Liberty and Cobber. It's two withdrawals, so you will move up if you can understand. The pole draw was made before the withdrawal, so listen very carefully. Heartache in pole position one. Contagious, pole position two.
What's wrong with it?
Drivers, could you raise your hands if you get that? Thank you. Pole position three, Think Pink.
I don't think so.
Four. Can I find it?
I was always told to wish for luck.
Trust Me is a withdrawal. Five, Liberty. Thank you. Six, Cobber. Not out there yet. Seven, Misprint. Eight, Maniac. Nine, Repeater is a withdrawal. 10, Black Russian. 11, Rough Nut. Thank you. 12, Possessed. Thank you. 13, Chapter 4. Thank you. And 14, PJ. Thank you. So as soon as we have Black Russian, Cobber, and Main Maniac is out on the water. Waiting on Black Russian. Cobber is not here, someone just said.
He's getting you about there.
Right, thank you. Well, we're only waiting on Black Russian and Think Pink to come out.
Think Pink's out.
Thank you, Black Russian. That looks like all the starters we have. Start boat, you can take them away. You are in the starter's hand, driver. We pick up the field as they come up for a start. Flag down, they're racing. Oh, one of them's got a bit of a hook. Between the lead two boats, looks like Possessed just in front of Maniac as they go out of the boy the first time. The next one then would be Liberty, followed by BJ, then Black Russian on the outside of Black Russian. Very hard to pick up that other boat, but I think it is... Chapter 4, it was the one I couldn't pick up. Then we have Heartache, Contagious and Rough Nut. We'll get them properly though as they come past for the second time. Then we have Heartache, all contagious, and to take off, he would have been able to qualify. once again, it's all possessed though. As they go up towards their victory point, then we have Maniac and Liberty, Ding Dong Battle for second and third. But it's all possessed as they go in towards the victory point for the second time. There comes Possessed once again. Screaming as he pauses coming out of the one to start running. The next one, that would be Liberty from Maniac. Not much between these two, but Maniac just takes him as he goes past. Back to the net, put the foot out again. Has to go wide, loud. Liberty has come up a lot more. The next one would be Black Russian from Chapter 4. No, yes, it is Chapter 4 running next. And the next one would be Heartache from Charlie's a long way in front of Maniac and Liberty. Ding Dong Battle for second and third. Not much in it between these two boats. As we've got Little Rough Duck going past now. Yellow Flag will go out now. Four Possessed as he comes down. One left to go, Four Possessed. Barring up for these circumstances. Liberty makes a better turn than Maniac. Not much in it at all between these two boats. And Maniac puts the foot down now. And flies down towards the Yellow Flag in the carry. One left to go. Must be right off. Possessed as they go up the back straight once again. Coming down now though, we have Black Russian from Chapter 4. The next one then would be Heartache. And we have Black Russian from the Chapter 4. The next one, Heartache, five by Constation. A long way back to front nine. It will be up by Possessed. Looks like Liberty has lost a lot of ground on there. PJ got going again out the back straight. Second flag for Possessed. Completes the course, only waiting on Rough Nut and PJ's to finish.
He's betting his Black Russian's playing small block. He'll go on the 6 loop, then, won't he?
Waiting and see PJ does come up. I think he thinks he's... Falls to the centre of the course or not. Still got to go around if he wants to finish the event.
Who's that?
No, he's pulling to the centre of the course. The Black Reef will...
Who's that, Ruffy?
Hang on a minute, he's changed his mind again. He's pulled out though. The Black Reef all flag will go out. PJ.
Oh, what? Sunglasses.
Well, pole positions are as follows. Red Lightning in one, Neptune Marine in two, Neptune Marine in three, Vengeance in two, Motor Oil in four. I'll repeat those once more. Red Lightning in one, Vengeance in two, Neptune Marine in three, Motor Oil in four. You're in the hands of the pole boat, drivers.
This is open outboard championship. One more boat to come out, drivers. I'll give you your pole positions once again. In pole position one, Water Bitch. In two, Cujo. In three, Running Wild, who is a withdrawal. In four, Can't Member. In five, Special Girl. Six, Foot Rot. Seven, Cut Loose. Eight, Bloodshot. And nine is Keen. We're only waiting on one boat. This is the 4.2 inboard.
It looks like Footrod is not here as well. So we have all starters out there. Start boats, you can take them away. You are in the starter's hand, drivers. to get drivers of handicap boats if you're going into a handicap event. It is the next event. Also, the drivers in the Ken Wagon Memorial, if you have your program handy, don't forget. Another one of our big sponsors is Bob Jane T-Mart for all your tyres and needs, and shirts and tyres for your cars and counterweight weight balancing, and that goes to Bob Jane T-Mart. So we pick up the wheel and cut loose, comes fast and now from Special Girl. On the inside there is Hugh Jones, and we have Keen, Bloodshot Waterbitch, and Card member at the rear of the field. Cut loose as they come out of the fix, the southern end of the course for the first time from Special Girl. Then we have Kia Joe, Bloodshot is the next one, followed by Keen, Can't Member. No, it is not Keen. Keen is at the rear of the field, I'd say, looking by the green deck from here. That one is Waterbitch alongside Can't Member, who's just being overtaken by Can't Member. Watch them as they come out of the northern end of the course for the first time. It's Can't Cut Loose. We have a caution flag. We have Keen broken down out on the other end of the course. I think he's off course now. But it is Cut Loose from Special Girl. Then we have Cujo. Bloodshot is the next boat, followed by Waterbitch and Can't Member. We have the crash boat going over to Keen. A lot of steam coming out of that motor. It's all cut loose though from Special Girl. Kierjo is the next boat from Bloodshot. Cut loose will come down this time to receive the yellow flag indicating one lap to go. The only two events that are four lappers, ladies and gentlemen, are the Ken Wagon Memorial and the Northern Districts. All other races are three laps, except for those two races. Here comes Cut Loose down now, receives the yellow flag. One lap to go for Cut Loose. Next one then is Special Girl. Can be taken down now. They have pulled the boat off course on the other side of the court. Next one through is Bloodshot. From the Can't Member, and the rear of the field is Waterbitch. Out of the southern end of the course for the final time, it's all cut loose from Special half to Cut Loose. Lefty's run a bit late. Just keep our eye on Cujo as he goes up the back straight, because that's where the big holes are up there. Getting out of the water a bit is Cujo, but it's all cut loose as they go into the final point for the final time. Very nice turn there by Cujo. But it's cut loose to come down to receive the checkered flag. Special Girl will come through in third place, followed by Bloodshot. So we have Bloodshot finishing. Only waiting on Can't Member and Waterbitch to complete the course. Keen wasn't on finisher, did break down. A bit of bad luck there for Keen. There we have Can't Member finishing. Only waiting on Waterbitch to finish the event. Waterbitch finishing this. Still waiting on two to receive the yellow. They are Waterbitch and Chapter 4. Charlie Duckett and even Stevens have gone a long way out in front as they go off the back straight. And it's past the boats. It's got to go a bit quicker. They think that he's gone for the doctor, so they're going to stay out with him. The next one then would be Carandra, followed by Arkin Hill. Then we've got Cookie. Desperado would be the next boat. Snatch is the next one, or 162 as we are calling it, because they have no name on the boat this weekend. Next one would be Roughnut, I think, from Trust V Red Lightning. Heartache going in between Chapter 4 and another boat on the outside there. They come down for a finish in this combined handicap. Don't forget, drivers in the second heat of the Wagon, you must have your boats in the water immediately. This event is over. It's going to be very tight as they come down for a finish though in this one. It's going to be Carandra, Even Stevens, Arkin Hill, Desperado, Cookie, three boats together there with Rusty, Snatch and Rusty. Then we have Red Lightning, Heartache, followed by Outcast, The next one, Cujo, can't remember. Still waiting on two to finish. They are Chapter 4 and Water Beach. Here we have Chapter 4 finishing now, only waiting on Water Beach to finish. So drivers of boats in the second heat of the Ken Wagon Memorial, we want you out in front of the control tower as soon as the course is cleared. Flags down and they're racing. We'll try and pick them up as they come through for the first time. It's Repeater from Running Wild. There's one in the back there in the middle that I can't pick it out because of the watch. It looks like Walkabout. Yes, it's Walkabout running third at this stage from Hot Lemon. And they sort themselves out a bit better, but at this stage it's Repeater. Just in front of Running Wild as they go up the back straight for the first time. Then we have Walkabout. I think Cut Loose would be the next boat. Or is it Anguish? Yes, it's Anguish. Held by the Red Riding. Then we have Special Girl, I think that is. Very hard to tell when they're on this straight up and down course. What the three lead boats are though, they are Repeater, Running Wild and Walkabout. Keep our eye on as they go up the back straight once again, it's still Repeater from Running Wild. Running Wild's got a bit more trim this time. He's sitting out of the water a bit more than what he was in the first heat. Hello, Walkabout is dying as he goes up the back straight. You can hear him backfiring. He's got going again now though. Must have fueled up a little bit. Meantime though, Repeater comes down past the start finishing line once again. Next time round he will receive the yellow flag indicating one lap to go. Running Wild would be the next boat. From Walkabout. Then we've got Anguish. One just coming around the buoy now would be Cut Loose from Special Girl. Colonel would be the next one. Hot Lemon in the rear of the field is Think Pink. They go out the back straight for once again. It is still Repeater from Running Wild. This time round, the Repeater will receive the yellow flag indicating one lap to go. Repeater and Running Wild both received the yellow flag. One lap to go for those two boats. Looks like they could lap Think Pink and Hot Lemon. Next one through will be Walkabout receives the yellow flag. One lap to go for Walkabout. Also Anguish, one lap to go. Next one will be Cut Loose from the Colonel. Then Special Girl. Colonel, Special Girl both get the yellow flag. One lap to go for those two boats. We have a caution flag up. We've had a bit of our luck for Running Wild, stopped on the back straight. Hot Lemon gets the yellow, Think Pink gets the yellow, Repeater will get the checkered flag. All boats receive the yellow. Repeater has run the race again. Of course, ladies and gentlemen, these positions are unofficial until we get the AOK from the start boat. Walkabout should come through in second place. Bit of our luck there for Running Wild, didn't break down on the finish. But Repeater did come through first. Walkabout comes through second. Third placing will go to Anguish. Fourth placing will go to Cut Loose from the Colonel. And we have Cut Loose, Colonel. Only waiting on the next one, which is Special Girl. Then we've got Hot Lemon and Think Pink. Still waiting on Hot Lemon and Think Pink. Bit of bad luck there for Running Wild. Was going extra well in second place. There we have Hot Lemon, Think Pink finishing now. That's all boats completed. The black recall flag will go out indicating they may return to the marina. Bring up the speeds of well in excess of 130 k's out there. So the boats we want out in front of the control tower for the next event, which is the 6 litre. Probably Repeater needs a bit of time to refuel. He's in the event also. Colonel's in the event also. think Pink, I think, is in the event, yeah. But first placing the second heat of the Ken Wagon Memorial goes to Rafita.
Are in the hands of the pole boat Star. This is an unlimited, unrestricted championship, heat two of the Alan Hathrell Memorial. See some very, very fast boats here with a couple of Formula One tunnels and also a couple of blown boats. They're lining up now. Lining up for a start. It's quite a good field here. Over there, terrible accident. There's Craig Bailey going in there. It looks like it's Nicholas Ames that's come unstuck. Craig Bailey's also got a hole in his boat. two arms ups indicate that the boat is in a sinking mode. Nicholas Ames' boat has gone over. Rescue boats are there. Yes, well, they retrieved the boat. It was Neptune Marine. Nicholas Lane, let's hope he's okay. There's Wayne Jones in possess there. They've all come in, they'll have to be rerun this race. So those boats will probably have to take some fuel. There's Nicholas Ames, he's okay. He's okay, he's cut out of it unscathed. Lucky man. Craig Bailey and Nicholas Ames have come together. I think both boats are pretty badly damaged, but both drivers are okay. Nicholas Ames is a little bit shaken at the moment. We hope to get a little bit of an interview with him a little bit later. There's Joe Ames, Nicholas' father, having a look at the boat at the moment. Must be some tremendous disappointment for this team that have been working so hard all year and done so well. And here comes a rerun of the Northern District Unlimited Championship. Craig Bailey's out there again. He's repaired a small impression in the boat. Up there and he's after the leader at the moment. There's Maniac punching out the horsepower down the straight. He comes into the bottom turn wide. Craig Bailey, who runs second. Coming to her rescue. She's been thrown clear from the boat. The boat's cutout switches worked immediately. She would have been shaken up by that. There's been some action here today at Toronto, the Royal Motor Yacht Club. Yes, they just lifted her into the boat now. She appears to be okay. Yes, the name of the boat was Rough Nut. The lady driver. We're coming up for a restart of the ladies' race after that accident. And they're into it again. boats are lining up now for the 4.6 litre inboard, and the flag is down and they're away.
Now. 10 wagon Memorial repeater doing 100 miles an hour down this back straight, coming into the corner now, backing off. Second and third fighting it out. Anguish. And the colonel.
Here they come for the 6 litre open inboard. They're all lined up spread across the field. The fade, they're away.
Liberty, I think, Black Russian. I'll hold that for you. I'll hold this up.
My tape would be the outside. There won't be tall starters or anything in the event, but you are on the outside, Heartache. Yes, the flight repeater and Liberty are the only two to come out tonight, but as soon as they come out, you can take them away. Don't forget, ladies, the next event is the ladies' handicap event.
There's all the big guns, they're in the starter's hands now.
Oh.
driven by the labels.
Only got three starters for the final of the Alan Hathrell. Last call for nomination for starters that are going in the final of the Alan Hathrell. If not, we'll give the poll draw for the three boats that are here. We have a boat refueling Rough Nut driver, so he did request time, but we didn't get it through until just now. Pole positions because of all the withdrawal drivers. In pole position 1, Rough Nut. In pole position 2, Maniac. In pole position 3, Heartache. And PJ's on the outside in 4. As soon as Rough Nut comes out, you will be in the starter's hand, drivers. Coming up for a start in the final of the Alan Hathrell Memorial. Bit of a shame that we've only got three starters at the boat as the racing. They are racing now, four starters I should say. Maniac one of the best away from the one on the inside here in PJ. Chapter 4, that's Chapter 4 on the inside of this stage from Repeater, not much in it though as they come down to Watson for the first time. Chapter 4 as they go out of that boy for the first time, but you watch Repeater go now, he straightens up to go up that back straight. As Ruffy just goes into the boy, I think they've got a different driver in Repeater now though. Chapter 4 going very well as they go into that boy. comes up that end of the course. Down this time, receive the yellow flag indicating one lap to go. He's really riding the boat. He's dragging it on as he goes down there now. And Ruffman's still going up the back straight. Watching closely as they go into the southern end of the course for the final time. But it's still chapter four just in front of Rapida, who's going up smartly now on the outside. Chapter 4 had a bit of a cough as he came out of that boy, but look at him go now, there's not much in it at all. Repeater at this stage, he's got a hold of there though, because Chapter 4 has been cornering a lot better than Repeater. Chapter 4 comes in underneath, it's going to be another one of those races, ladies and gentlemen. There's not much in it at all, it's going to be close between Repeater and Chapter 4. And a rough nut third. That completes racing for the day, ladies and gentlemen. We thank you very much. Don't forget, next year we hope the weather is better. Four Queens birthday weekend, and hope to see you all back again for the big weekend next year.
Carleen Stewart, you were driving a boat called Rough Nut today, and down on the bottom turn, boy, we saw you get catapulted out of that boat at about 60 or 80 miles an hour. Actually, you might have been going a bit faster than that. What actually happened in your terms?
Well, I came around the bend and thought I had it all under control, but I didn't, and hit what they call the pocket in the top turning buoy, and threw me out of the boat, literally. Came to a dead stop, and because I had the kill switch attached to my belt, was a definite safety feature, which is included in all the boats.
And that cut the motor out?
That's right.
How are you feeling yourself? Did you suffer any injuries?
Well, only bruising,
right,
which is luckily, it's not a big deal sort of thing. Pretty sore.
So
I'm sure tomorrow.
So you're going to get back in the boat again next race,
mate? No worries.
No worries.
No problem at all.
All right, well, yeah. It's good to see that you've come out of it okay, and
yes,
we've got some good footage on you, and I think you'll probably be shocked a bit when you see the footage yourself.
Yes, I probably will be too.
Thanks very much, Carleen.
Okay.
Thank you.